ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोद् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐमित्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् We go to the next sutra here, 2.1.24. It says, Upasamhara-darshanād naiti cet na kshiravaddhe. Upasamhara means to procure material, to collect material or procure material. For example, when you want to make chapati, you procure the material in the form of the wheat flour. Similarly, the pot maker wants to make a pot. He procures material in the form of clay. That's called upadanam. That's why it is called upadana karanam. So the wheat flour will be called the upadana karanam of the roti, or the clay would be called the upadana karanam of the pot. Upadiyate, that which is procured, collected, acquired, you take it. That's why it's called upadana karanam. Yes, upasamhara. Upasamhara darshanat. Loke kartuhu kulalasya danda chakradi upasamhara darshanat. You find that in our day-to-day life. Kartuhu kulalasya. Kulala means a pot maker who wants to create the pot. Then, when is he able to create it? Danda chakradi upasamhara darshanat. He goes for a danda, for a stick, chakra, for a wheel, etc. And clay, of course. So he acquires or procures this material. Na asahayam brahma. Therefore, na. Purupakshi says na means what? Na asahayam brahma jagatah prakriti nimittam va. So therefore, for the pot maker to create the pot, he requires material. That is called upadanam. He requires a potter's wheel. That's called nimittam. So you require upadana karanam and nimitta karanam. So nayayika is called all other causes as nimitta karanam, like the potter's wheel, chakra, that danda that he requires to revolve it. He requires a string to cut it. He requires some water. All of these materials he requires, all of this is called nimitta, instrumental cause. Material cause and instrumental cause. Meaning that the kulala or the pot maker alone cannot create the pot. He requires the help of this thing, sahaya, help. But Brahman is one without a second, without any help. Therefore, asahayam brahma, brahma which the Vedanta claims as asahayam, without any help, cannot be jagatah prakritihi. Prakriti means the material cause. Brahma cannot be the material cause of the creation. Nimittam va cannot be the instrumental cause either. Iti chet. So that is the purvapakshep. This is what you have to say. Then the Siddhanta says, na, that dosha or the defect that Brahma is asahayam, requires external sahaya, he requires external help, is not a necessary rule. We can show you an exception to that rule, that only with the help of external resources that you can create, you cannot create otherwise. Kshiravadhi. He. It is well known that kshira means milk. Yatha kshiram anya anapeksham. Just as milk, without the help of any external causes, dadhya karena parinamate. Milk on its own gets transformed as curd, without the help of any external factors. Tatha brahma api anya anapeksham jagat sarjanadi karoti. Similarly, brahma also, without depending upon anything. So what brahma does is a matter of is what shruti says, but what the shruti says is question based on the local observation. We observe that creation takes place only when certain conditions are satisfied. That a pot maker requires external help, support, resources. And Brahma does not have any external resources. It is ekameva dvitiyam, one without a second. How can it create? Therefore, Brahma cannot be the creator, nor can it be the material. It can neither be the maker nor the material. So thus, by raising these different purvapakshas, further and further clarity is given to us as to how Brahman is the jagat karanam, the cause of creation. Tat aikshata bahusyam. That's how Chandogya Upanishad presents Brahma as the nimitta karanam and upadana karanam also. जन्माद्यस्य यतः सो ऑल्सो ब्रह्मसूत्र सेज सो दैट इज बीइंग कंटेंडेड थ्रू आउट सो सेज रत्नप्रभा उपसंहार दर्शनात् पेज 396 असहायात् ब्रह्मणः जगत सर्गम ब्रुवन समन्वयो विषयः सो दिस वाज द टॉपिक द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर व्हाट इज इट जन्माद् यस्य यतः ब्रह्मन दैट इज वन विदाउट अ सेकंड इज द कॉज ऑफ क्रिएशन असहायात् ब्रह्मणः दैट ब्रह्मन डज नॉट हैव एनी अदर सहाया एनी अदर हेल्प बिकॉज इट इज वन विदाउट अ सेकंड सजातीय विजातीय स्वगत भेदरहित सजातीय दिस नो अदर ब्रह्मन विजातीय दिस नथिंग अदर देन ब्रह्मन स्वगत इज इट विल बी एक्सप्लेन्ड हियर वेदर इंटरनल डिविजन्स आर नॉट सो दिस वॉट सिद्धांत सेज जगत सर्गम ब्रुवन claiming that the creation is from Brahman, which is one without a second, that samanvaya, that is where the scriptures have their purport, fullest import, that's a vishaya, that is subject matter, which is being discussed here, which is, this conclusion is questioned again and again, from different standpoints. So, saha kim yat asahayam, तन्न कारणमिति लौकिक न्यायेन विरुध्यते नवा इति संदेहे लौकिक न्याय द रूल दैट वी अराइवेड बाय ऑब्जर्विंग अवर डे टू डे लाइफ सो अंडरस्टैंड दैट ऑल द रूल्स ऑफ लॉजिक आर डिराइव फ्रॉम अवर ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ अवर डेली लाइफ And the Purva Pakshi wants to extend that logic to Brahman also. And Vedantin accepts that challenge and shows the limitation of that logic or limitation of the claim of the Purva Pakshi by showing exception to the logic or rule. Exception to the rule. Meaning that the rule that you are claiming need not apply, that's all. It is not an invariable rule. It is a rule which is not certain. There is uncertainty in the rule that you are claiming. If you show exception to the rule, then that position gets refuted. So, kim yat asahayam tanna karanam this is our observation yat asahayam tanna karanam kulalavat that which is without external help cannot be the cause like a pot maker iti laukika nyaya this is a rule that we derive from our day to day life tena viruddhyate This samanvaya, this position of the Vedantin, that Brahma alone is the cause of the creation, that view of the Vedantin, does it contradict this rule that what is without help cannot create? That seems to be our observation from a pot maker. So, doubt is whether Brahman creates without any help, does that contradict our observation that nothing can create without external help? Or does not contradict? Iti sandehe. So both of these, so Purva Pakshi gives one rule, the Siddhanti gives another rule. So for the same creation, two contradictory rules are cited here. That's how sandeha is created, doubt is created. Now, then Ratnaprabha says, what is the relationship that this adhikaranam of the topic has with the previous topic, because there is a continuity of thought here. So what was established in the previous topic should form the background of the new topic. So purvam aupadhika jiva bhedat brahmani jiva dosha na prasajyante iti uktam. So in the earlier topic, the Purupaksha was that you are claiming the identity between Jiva and Brahma. And Brahma also you are claiming Brahma is Jagat Karanam. So Jiva is equal to Brahma and Brahma is equal to Jagat Karanam. Therefore, Jiva is Jagat Karanam. So, but Jiva has all kinds of doshas or defects, that sometimes Jiva winds up, the individual being winds up doing something that is hurtful to its own self, or fails to do something that is helpful to it. These doshas, if Jiva and Brahma are identical, then these defects pertaining to Jiva will also be applied to Brahman, because Jiva and Brahman are identical. The answer was given that even though Jiva is Brahma in its true nature, intrinsic nature, intrinsically Jiva and Brahma are identical. But as far as Upadhi is concerned, as far as the limiting adjunct is concerned, as far as the name and form is concerned, the costume is concerned, Brahma has a costume of Maya, Jiva has the costume of avidya or ignorance, and therefore from that standpoint they are different. Therefore Jiva gata dosha, therefore the doshas or defects obtaining in Jiva do not apply to Brahman. This is how the argument was in the previous topic. So purvam aupadhika jiva bhedat brahmani jiva dosha na prasajyante, because there is aupadhika bheda, there is bheda or duality at the level of costume, and therefore the defects obtaining in jiva do not get transformed to Brahma. All right, good. So that becomes the basis. The reply that you give becomes the basis for question here. Samprati upadhitopi vibhaktam brahmanah prerakadigam sahakari naste. All right, but upadhika bheda also is not there. In the beginning, when you are talking about creation, all there is Brahman, which you claim one without a second. So from the standpoint of Upadhi also, there is nothing other than Brahman. So Upadhi topi vibhaktam, even if the vibhaga or the division is not in the real sense, it is there only at the level of Upadhi of the costume. Even that kind of division also we do not find in the beginning of creation. And if Brahman is the material cause, then you require preraka, you require nimitta, you require something that in fact prompts it, you know. Nimitta karanam is prompted by the material cause is prompted by the efficient cause to form into an object such as a pot. So prerakadikam sahakari nasti. But at the beginning of creation, even if Brahman is material cause, what is a nimitta? There is nothing, no nimitta, no preraka. Ish nanatva abhavat. Why not we say there is another Brahman? So this Brahman is prompted by another Brahman to form into the world. Says, no, no, ish nanatva abhavat. There are not many Ishwaras, not many Brahma. Brahma is one without a second. Therefore, it cannot be that one Brahman prompts another Brahman. Cannot be. Iti pratyudaharanena. So same argument is taken and reversed. Pratyudaharanena. पूर्व पक्ष सूत्रांशम व्याचस्ते, पूर्व पक्ष इज एक्सप्लेन बाय भाष्यकार. बिफोर दैट वी कैन गो टू दी वैयासिक न्यायमाला. न संभवेत समवेद्वा सृष्टिरेका द्वितीयतः नाना जातीय कार्याणां क्रमाज्जन्म न संभवे. अद्वैतम तत्वतो ब्रह्म तच्चा विद्या सहायवत नाना कार्यकर्म कार्य क्रमो विद्यास्त शक्तिभिः. सो हियर द टीका सेज एकमेवाद्वितीयमिति ब्रह्मणः स्वगत सजातीय विजातीयैः भेदैः शून्यत्वम् अवगम्यते. उपनिषत् सेज सदैव सौम्य इदमग्र आसीत् एकमेवाद्वितीयम् एकम् एव अद्वितीयम् स्वगत सजातीय विजातीय भेदरहितम्. So this is what we understand from the statement of the Shruti. Brahmanah shunyatvam bhedaihi shunyatvam, that Brahman is devoid of all divisions. There is no division of a similar kind, of a different kind, or no internal divisions. So Brahman is one. Without inner divisions, homogeneous. One is one homogeneous, undivided, indivisible whole. That's what Brahman is. Undivided and indivisible. Whereas, srashtavyani cha akashavayu agnyadini vichitrani. This is different from actually what the discussion is here, by the way. This Vaiyasika Nyayamala has its own thought pattern. It is included here, but then, anyway, so, Srashtavyanicha Akashavayavajnyadini Vichitrani. So, what is created has variety. Brahman is devoid of any variety at all. No division without or within. So, an undivided, homogeneous whole, how can it create the variegated world? See, this was the argument that Sankhyas have for establishing that Pradhanam is the Jagat Karanam. Brahman cannot be the material cause, because material cause should have in nature similar to the effect. In the creation we find the play of the three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas. But Brahman doesn't have sattva, rajas, tamas. They have a pradhanam, the primordial matter which is made up of sattva, rajas, tamas. That must be the material cause. This is how Sankhyas argue. Here it says, Brahman cannot be the material cause, because Brahman does not have the potential of creating the diversified product. The universe consists of lots of variety and diversity, whereas Brahman, the material cause, is devoid of all diversity, all variety. Nahi avichitre karane कार्य वैचित्र्यम युक्तम. When कारणम or the cause does not have विचित्रता, the variation, variegatedness inside, diversity inside, how can the effect of the product be having diversity? But जगत has diversity and Brahman does not have diversity, the Brahman cannot be the cause of the जगत. We may ask him, why do you insist that the cause must be nature similar to effect? There should be compatibility between the effect and the cause. Why? He says, anyatha ekasmadeva kshirad daditailadi अनेक विचित्र कार्य प्रसंगात। इफ समथिंग कैन बी क्रिएटेड फ्रॉम व्हेन देयर इज नो पोटेंशियल, द कॉज मस्ट हैव द पोटेंशियल ऑफ क्रिएटिंग द इफेक्ट। इफेक्ट इज वेरीगेटेड, द कॉज ऑल्सो शुड हैव द वेरीगेटेड बिल्ट इन वेरीगेटेडनेस विद इन। इफ दैट इज नो रूल, देन फ्रॉम वन मिल्क यू कैन क्रिएट दधि कर्ड एंड तैल ऑयल ऑल्सो, वाई नॉट। इफ एनीथिंग कैन बी क्रिएटेड फ्रॉम एनीथिंग, then from a lemon seed you can also create a mango tree, because you say that the cause need not be compatible to the effect. So then the situation will be that from the milk curd and oil and all kinds of different substances are created. That's one thing. This is one inconsistency between the cause and effect. Other inconsistency is karmascha akashadinam shrutya avagamyate. See, this creation takes place in an order. It's not that it just takes place like that. Tasmadva etasmad atmanah akasha sambhutah akashad vayuhu वायोः अग्निः अग्नेः आपः अद्भ्यः पृथिवी। सो फ्रॉम दैट ब्रह्म विच इज दिस आत्मा फर्स्ट इमर्ज द स्पेस, फ्रॉम स्पेस द एयर, फ्रॉम एयर द फायर, फ्रॉम फायर द वाटर, फ्रॉम वाटर द अर्थ। इज द क्रम। सो दैट पोटेंशियल ऑल्सो शुड बी देयर इन द कॉज। So, the cause of creation should have two kinds of potentials. One is, it must have a built-in diversity so that a diverse creation can be, the universe can be created. And it must have a built-in order so that an orderly universe can be created. Nacha tasya vyavasthapakam kinchid asti. But in Brahman being homogeneous and whole, there is nothing that is vyavasthapaka, that will put a proper order. Vyavastha means order. Vyavasthapaka, one who puts proper order in the things, you know. So in Brahman there is no potential or there is no factor in Brahman that will order or that will determine this particular order. Because Brahman is homogeneous. Tasmat aneka karyanam kramena janmat advitiya brahmana na sambhavati. Janma advitiya brahmana na sambhavati. Therefore, two things are there. Aneka karyanam, universe, that is aneka karya, a diverse creation is there. Kramena janma, and the janma or the creation is in a certain order. Advitiya brahmana, so Brahman which is without any help and without any internal diversity. From Brahman such as that, how can this universe be created? It defies all the logic. Universe being created from Brahman defies all the logic. So how can it be? This is the Purva Paksha. Iti prapte brumaha. So when this position is, when this claim or this position is attained, then this is what we have to say. Yadyapi tattvatah brahma advaitam. Yadyapi tattvatah brahma maya. The Vedantin always has the last stroke, maya, you know. So it is true, tattvatah. Intrinsically, Brahman is advaitam. Brahma is non-dual. without any external or internal divisions in true nature. Tathapi avidya sahayo petamiti. But still, Brahman is accompanied with ignorance or maya. Now, this is something that we derive, understand. The Shruti does not say Brahman with maya created it, or Brahman with ignorance created it. But we derive that, because had maya or ignorance not been there, creation would not be possible. Brahman itself does not have any potential for creation. Therefore, Vedantins bring in a factor called maya. Why should creation take place? Maya. How does creation take place? Maya. Why means there is no reason. You cannot assign any reason to creation, any purpose to creation. No purpose is to be served. Because Brahman doesn't have a purpose. And Brahman is the only one before the creation, and Brahman doesn't have any need, any purpose. So, therefore, Shruti Yukti Anubhavaihi Avagamyate. From Shruti, of course, there is, thank God, one statement there. Mayam tu prakritim vidyat, mayinam tu maheshwaram. Or Indro mayabhi pururupah iyate. So these are a few places where the word maya is used. So Shrutya, from Shruti we can say that mayam tu prakritim vidyat. Maya is the material cause, prakriti. Mayinam tu maheshwaram, and maheshwara, the paramatma, the chaitanya, is mayi or mayavi or the master of maya. So maya is the material cause and mayavi is the efficient cause. It is shrute. So shruti yukti also. That because there is no purpose in Brahman, we cannot assign any purpose of this creation. Therefore, there has to be a factor which brings about this creation, which is not real, which is subject to negation. It is mithya, and mithya is always the creation of maya. Therefore, there must be maya. So all these irreconcilable positions are reconciled by this factor called the maya, like the 18th elephant. So 18th elephant solves all the problems and then is withdrawn. Anubhavaihi avagamyate. We see in our day-to-day life a magician creates alone. It is not a rule that you always require an external factor to create. How a magician creates without any external help. So, Anubhava also is there, Yukti also is there, Shruti also is there. But the Shruti uses the word Maya, and you are saying Avidya. Avidya Sahayopetam. Brahman is endowed with the sahaya, the help of ignorance. But where is ignorance? So says maya eva avidya. Maya is, I mean, ignorance. Why? Ubhayoho api anirvachaniyatva lakshanasya ekatva. Because what is maya? Anirvachaniya, which cannot be categorized as is or is not. So also ignorance is anirvachaniyam, cannot be categorized. Both have the similar characteristics. Therefore, maya and avidya are one. So sometimes they are differentiated. Sometimes the upadhi of Ishvara is called Maya and upadhi of Jiva is called Avidya. So Samashti is called Maya, Vyashti is called Avidya. For the purpose of explaining our experiences, this kind of tentative divisions are made. But then if you look at the intrinsic characteristic, then Maya also is anirvachaniya, Avidya also is anirvachaniya. In that sense, both are not intrinsically different. There were sometimes word Avidya also is used for Maya. But oh, Vedantin, you are accepting Maya? So Brahman has the help of Avidya or Maya? That means there is a second factor. In that case, how do you claim that Brahman is non-dual? Brahman is one, Maya is another one, so there is duality. Nacha Maya Angikare Dvaita Pattihi. No. By accepting Maya, there is no occasion for Dvaita or duality. It does not amount to, or we do not arrive at the duality. Why? Brahman is one, Maya is one. It says, no, no. Vastavasya dvitiyasya abhava. The Maya is as though different, not really different, because Brahman is distinct from Maya, but Maya is not distinct from Brahman. B is equal to A is not equal to B. So there is actor and there is beggar. So there seems to be a seeming difference between the two, but beggar is not an entity separate from actor. So if you want to offer a cup of tea to the actor, you need not get another cup for the beggar, because beggar is included in the actor. Beggar doesn't have an existence independent of the actor. Vastavasya dvitiyasya abhavat. Therefore, Maya does not pose a duality, because Maya does not have an existence independent of Brahman. The idea is that even though we accept something called Maya, it does not in any way violate the non-duality of Brahman. Brahman still remains non-dual. Atah ekamapi brahma avidya sahayavashat nana karyakaram bhavishyati. Therefore, one Brahman with the help of avidya can bring about a variety of product, because avidya or ignorance or maya has all the potential of diversity and of order also. Even though the jagat is mithya, it is an orderly jagat, you know. So that is what is baffling. Even though jagat is mithya, it is very systematic, very orderly. And that is why one is inclined to take the jagat as real, because it is so orderly. So that order also is contained in Maya, and diversity also is contained in Maya. Therefore, the diversity of the jagat and order of the jagat, both of them can be explained by Maya, which is the Sahaya, which so Brahman has a support help in the form of avidya or Maya. Nacha karyakramastya vivasthapaka abhavah. With Maya being there, karya krama. Karya means effect, krama means order. So karya krama means an order that we find in the if creation. Karya means creation, krama means order. Karya krama means the order in creation. Nacha karya kramasya vyavasthapak abhavah. There is no absence of that which prompts the order. Avidyagatanam shakti visheshanam व्यवस्थापकत्वात् बिकॉज अविद्या और इग्नोरेंस और माया हैज वैरायटी ऑफ पावर्स इट इज दी ज्ञान शक्ति पावर ऑफ नॉलेज इच्छा शक्ति पावर ऑफ विल क्रिया शक्ति पावर ऑफ एक्शन सो दिस वैरायटी ऑफ पावर्स आर देयर इन माया सो वैरायटी कैन बी देयर इन द क्रिएशन At the same time, the order also can be there. These powers will order an orderly creation. So it is a diverse creation. It is an orderly creation. All of these are prompted the Sankhyas and Vaisheshikas and Nayayikas to arrive at variety of material causes for the universe. Vedanta has one stroke, namely Maya. Because the Jagat is Mithya. Those people accepted Jagat as real. That is why they arrived at these conclusions. But Vedanta says Jagat is Mithya. Why do you say the duality must be Mithya? How do you say that? Because Upanishad says Tattvamasi, you are Brahman. So, or sarvam khalvidam brahma, whatever is brahman. Matta parataram nanyat kinchidasti dhananjaya, he dhananjaya, there is nothing other than me. All of these statements declare non-duality of brahman. The non-duality can be real only if duality is not real. So one of the two has to be right and another thing has to be wrong. Or one of the two has to be satyam, other has to be mithya. But ekameva dvitiyam sarvam khalvidam brahma aham brahmasmi atme vedam sarvam brahma vedam sarvam. All these statements reveal the non-duality. For Vedantins, these are all Mahavakyas, these are all the major statements. And therefore, how do you explain duality? It must be apparent, like the duality of my reflections in many mirrors, or the duality of the sun being reflected in many buckets, how the manyness of reflections is not a reality, is an appearance. Similarly, the duality is an appearance, not a reality. That's how Vedantin thinks. And that is how he arrives at Maya. First, non-duality is real. Therefore, duality has to be apparent. If duality is real, non-duality cannot be real. So duality is apparent like dream. So it must be a projection. Therefore, there must be a projecting power. That is Maya, which creates Mithya. Therefore, avidya gatanam shakti visheshanam vivasthapakatvat. The different powers that are intrinsic to ignorance or maya, that's called vikshepa shakti. Avidya is this avarana and vikshepa. What is vikshepa? The projecting power. So within ignorance, now we have so many tables, by the way. You can use these tables, you know. We have made tables for everybody. So you don't have to write like this. Therefore, tasmad advitiya brahmanah nana karyanam kramena srushtihi sambhavati. This is a different line of argument. Therefore, advitiya brahmanah, from Brahman there is non-dual, nana karyanam kramena srushtihi sambhavati. The karya of the universe, that is diverse as well as orderly. This is possible from ignorance, even though that does not in any way jeopardize the non-duality of Brahman, Advitiya Brahmanaha, from Brahman, that is non-dual, the Jagat, which has diversity and which has order, that creation is possible. So that's what the Vaiyasika Nyayamala said. Now we come to the Bhashya. Nyaya Nirnaya says the same thing as Ratna Prabha. Asahayat Brahmana Jagat Sargam Bruvan Samanvayo Vishaya. Samanvaya is the Vishaya. Sakim Brahma Na Upadanam Asahayatvat Sammatavat Iti Nyayana. We saw this. That Sammatavat, it is accepted that a kulal or a pot maker requires sahaya, requires help of external factors for creation. That is a general rule which is not applicable. Brahman does not satisfy that rule. Therefore, can Brahman be the cause or not? Iti tat anabhasatva abhasatva abhyam sandehe. Whether that argument that you necessarily require a sahaya, is it a real genuine argument or is it an apparent argument? Is it a, does it have an exception or not? It is sandeha, purvatra, etc., etc. So, Chetanamiti, Subhashyakara says, so Purupaksha Sutramsam Vyachaste. What is Purupaksha? Upasamhara Darshanat Na Iti. That is Purupaksha. Because we see Upasamhara, we see that many materials or accessories are procured before the creation can take place in our day-to-day life. And that is not there in case of Brahman. Therefore, Brahman cannot be Jagat Karanam. That is the Purupaksha. So there are two aspects of Upasamhara Darshanat and Na. So Purupaksha Sutra Amsham Vyachaste, first Amsha, first part, Upasamhara Darshanat. This is what Bhashyakara first explains. Chetanam Ityadina. So Bhashya says, Chetanam Brahma Ekamadvitiyam Jagatah Karanam Iti Yaduktam Tanna Upapadyate. Chetanam Brahma, this is Samanvaya. Chetanam Brahma Ekam Advitiyam Jagatah Karanam Iti Yaduktam, stated in the first chapter of Brahma Sutra, that Brahman, which is Chetanam, consciousness, Ekam, Advitiyam, one without a second, Jagatah Karanam. So Vedanta claims that Brahman such as that, Brahman which is consciousness and one without a second, is the cause of creation. What is meant by cause, and particularly material cause? What is meant is that, see, material cause is the very essence of the effect, with the self of the effect. So the Vedantin means to say that, look, behind this Jagat, whatever be the nature of Jagat, there the names and forms are limited, there is a lot of Dukkha and Sukha, etc. in Jagat. This is the Samsara. But Urdhva Moolam Adashakam, the tree of samsara has its root above. This limited Jagat has its root in limitless. Very important. So it doesn't matter what the jagat looks like. What the samsara is does not matter. What matters is, what is the root of that? What is the essence of that? What is the truth of that? It is very comforting. Otherwise, jagat itself is very disappointing. Constant conflicts are there. Constant struggle is there. Constant pain is there. It is also like an ocean, unending series of conflicts and struggles and pains. For most people, there may be some people who are luckier, but then for most people. And therefore life would have no hope at all. Where will all this lead to? Vedanta says, don't worry. This is all mithya, this is all apparent. Even when there appears to be dukkham or pain on the surface, intrinsically what there is ananda. Asti bhati priyam satchit ananda is the reality of this universe. This is all mithya, don't worry. So this is the most important contribution anywhere in the world. Nobody else has said this. Only Upanishads say that. So, Chetanam Brahma, Ekam Advitiyam, Jagatah Karanam. Karanam is Jagatah Atma, Matsthani Sarabhutani. The whole universe is stationed in me, rooted in me, meaning superimposed upon me. I am the Atma. It is because of me that Jagat has Atmavatvam, that Jagat has a content. I am the content of the universe. Iti yaduktam, this is what Vedantinu said, tat na upapadyate, that is not in keeping with upapatti or reason. So Shruti says that. See, what is the first chapter? First chapter is what the Shruti says, called Shravanam. Tatparya Nirnaya. So in the first chapter, we arrived at the Tatparya, the purport of Shruti, that is called Samanvaya, Samanvaya, purport. That Ekameva Dvitiyam Brahma is Jagat Karana. That is the Pratignya. Janmadyasya Yataha. That Jagat Janma, the creation is, origin is not this Pradhanam, not this Anu, not the Paramanu, it is Brahman. Then throughout that was established. So now that Tatparya Nirnaya, called Samanvaya, is questioned with logic. This is called Mananam. Mananam is establishing that position with reasoning. Therefore, all the time here we find Purupakshi comes up with reasons to question that conclusion of Shruti. So Shruti is questioned here. Tanna upadyate, what Shruti says, that Brahma ekameva dvitiyam is jagat karanam, cause of creation, that is not in keeping with upapatti, in keeping with reasoning. So we ask, kasmat. Hey, why, how do you say that? What makes you say that it is not logical that Brahman can be jagat karanam? What's the reason? So then the Purupakshi says, upasamhara darshanat. So this is one part of the sutra. Upasamhara darshanat, darshanat. Because in our day-to-day life, we find that we always require the sahaya, require also the help of factors, external factors other than you. So Bhashyakara explains that. That's what Nyaya Nirnaya says, loke karana bheda deva कार्य भेद दर्शनात्. इन वर्ल्ड वी फाइंड दैट ओनली इफ देयर इज डाइवर्सिटी इन द कॉज देयर कैन बी डाइवर्सिटी इन इफेक्ट. अन्यथा तत् आकस्मिकत्व आपातात्. इफ द पोटेंशियल इज नॉट देयर इन द कॉज एंड यू फाइंड द इफेक्ट, देन हाउ डू एक्सप्लेन इट? If somebody makes idli out of clay, then there is a problem here, because clay does not have potential of idli. Akasmika, what? It is something accident, meaning it is not reasonable, it's not logical. Karyakramasya cha karanakrama apekshatvat. In the orderliness that we see in the universe must also be potentially there in the cause. So cause must have potential diversity and orderliness. Then the universe can be diverse and orderly. Advitiye brahmani kramavat sahakari sambandha abhavat. But Brahman is non-dual. What is non-dual? There is nothing other than Brahman. Atmava idameka eva grasit nanyat kinchana mishata. All of this was Atma alone and nothing else winked. There was nothing conscious or unconscious other than Atma. So, sahakari sambandha abhavat. So, Brahman does not have any sahakara, does not have any help in terms of something that can have potential of diversity and order. Aikarupyacha. And Brahman is homogeneous. Two things. Brahman does not have any support and Brahman doesn't have potential. Even if Brahman did not have support of something else, if Brahman had potential within itself, but Aikarupyat is homogeneous, so it doesn't have diversity or orderliness. Na kramavat vichitra rupa jagat janma hetuta. Therefore, Brahman cannot have hetuta, cannot have causality of creating jagat of the universe, which has diversity and which has order. Ya ihahi. That's what Bhashyakara explains. Ihahi loke kulaladayah ghatapatadinam kartarah मृद्दंड चक्र सूत्रादि अनेक कारकोपसंहारेण संगृहीत साधना संतः तत्तत् कार्यं कुर्वाणाः दृश्यन्ते. यह ही लोके इन अवर day to day life here in this world. Kulaladaya. People suggest kulala, the pot maker or a weaver. Mrud. So a pot maker acquires mrud or clay. Danda or a rod. Chakra or a wheel. Sutra or a string. Ityadi. अनेक कारक उपसंहारेण. एंड फॉर पटा ही विल रिक्वायर अदर थिंग्स. द वीवर विल रिक्वायर अदर काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. सो उपसंहारेण बिफोर दे क्रिएट, बिफोर द पॉट मेकर क्रिएट्स अ पॉट, ही इक्विप्स हिमसेल्फ विथ ऑल द नेसेसरी एक्सेसरीज एंड देन ओनली ही प्रोसीड्स टू क्रिएट. ही जस्ट डजंट स्टार्ट क्रिएटिंग यू नो विदाउट प्रॉपर प्रेपरेशन. So sangruhita sadhanaha santah, becoming those who have equipped themselves with necessary sadhana or necessary instrumental cause or necessary accessories. Tat tat karyam kurvanaha drushyante. Depending upon whatever it is that they want to create, accordingly they acquire appropriate accessories. So a weaver will not acquire what a pot maker acquires. and a goldsmith will acquire with something else. So goldsmith is the creator, pot maker is the creator, weaver is the creator. Tat tat karyam. They create their own things, and for that they acquire the respective accessories which are necessary for those creations. अत्र साधन शब्द तत्त सामग्रीं ब्रूते सो संग्रहीत साधनाः साधन मीन सामग्री मीन्स वेरियस मटेरियल्स वेरियस इंग्रेडिएंट्स और वेरियस एक्सेसरीज समटाइम्स इंग्रेडिएंट्स समटाइम्स एक्सेसरीज सो सेज न्याय निर्णय व्हाट इज द आर्ग्यूमेंट ब्रह्म न उपादानम असहायत्वात् केवलं मृद्वत ब्रह्म न उपादानम ब्रह्म कैनॉट बी उपादानम अदि मटेरियल कॉज व्हाई असहायत्वात् बिकॉज इट डज नॉट हैव एनी सहाय और हेल्प केवलं मृद्वत जस्ट एज ओनली क्ले Without the support of the pot maker, cannot create a pot. Clay alone, without the sahaya, the help of pot maker, etc. Even clay also requires the potter's wheel and everything else, cannot create. The Brahma also cannot be the material karanam because it doesn't have the, it is not the material cause because it doesn't have a creator, a prayeraka. Adhishthanam, something that will prompt it, something that will form it, it is not there. Brahma jagatah na nimittam, and Brahma cannot be even nimitta karanam, cannot be the efficient cause of creation. Why? Asahayatvat, again because it is without any help or support. Kevala kumbhakaravata, just as a pot maker alone cannot create a pot, without the help of clay and the wheel, etc. So Brahma also cannot be nimitta karanam, nor can it be, because nimitta karanam also requires help and upadana karanam also requires help. Nimitta karanam requires upadana karanam. Upadana karanam requires nimitta karanam. So without the help, none of them can create. So you tell us, is Brahman upadana karanam? It cannot because it requires nimitta karanam. You say Brahman is nimitta karanam. That cannot because nimitta karanam requires upadana karanam. So asahayam Brahma. Brahman without the sahaya or the support of other cause cannot create. So that's the argument. Or says Ratnavara. Phalam Purvavat. What is Phalam? If Purvapaksha is right, then your Samanvaya is wrong. If Siddhanti is right, then Samanvaya is right. What is Karaka Upasamharena? Bhashyakara said, Aneka Karaka Upasamharena. What is Upasamhara? Karakana Upasamhara Meranam. Assembling, you know, gathering. Gathering the different accessories. Ukta Anumana. Then, therefore it says, Bhashyakara Brahma Chaiti. Brahma Cha. असहायम् तव अभिप्रेतम् तस्य साधनांतर अनुपसंग्रहे सति कथम् श्रष्टृत्वम् उपपद्येत ब्रह्मच असहायम् तव अभिप्रेतम् वेदांतिन यू हैव एक्सेप्टेड ब्रह्म एज असहायम् विदाउट any sahaya, without any help, without any support. So by those reasonings, without support, Brahman can neither be the material cause nor the efficient cause. Tasya sadhanantara anupasangrahe sati. When Brahman does not have other accessories to support it, katham srashtutvam upapadyeta. How can Brahman be the creator? How can Brahman be the nimitta karanam or upadana karanam? Ukta anumana phalam upasamharati. So what's the result of that anumanam? Tasmat na brahma jagat karanam iti chet. So na chet. Tasmat na, that na is also from the sutra. Brahma jagat karanam. Therefore, Brahma cannot be jagat karanam, cannot be the cause of creation. Iti chet, upasamhara darshana na iti chet. If this is your position, then this is our answer. So that's how first the Purvapaksha is built up, and then the Siddhanti answers that. We'll continue tomorrow.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutrabhashyakrutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmeri Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.